This egg is infertile, Kevin. It's not gonna hatch. I did not pay for space at the farmer's market.
Look how she just...
Bro, that's vintage. Oh, Kevin!
Look at that cleavage.
Almost made it.
See, guys, sometimes he listens to reason. What's up, guys? It's me, Uncle Ben, and I'm getting jacked, but I'm not gonna show you the results until 3 weeks from now.
That's right. Uncle Ben's going sicko mode. For some reason, Poggers is in this little area. Poggers, you're bad for that. No. Get out of there, Pog Boy. You're not supposed to be in there, man. Ducks keep getting out because there's a little hole right there. It's really annoying, but the big ducks can't get out. I gotta get some more food for the pigs today because they're being noisy. We're running low on food for these pigs. Come on, Poggers, let's go. Come on. Looks like Karen laid an egg, but this one's way too small to hatch. And there was another one in here that I saw last night. But I think that's why Poggers was in here. I think Poggers ate the egg, the little dingus. Get in there, Poggers. You're in solitary confinement in this really nice, large, open space. And to add insult to injury, I'm opening this up. There we go. And now we got all kinds of new green pasture land for these little guys to run around on. And man, look at that grass, you guys. It's amazing. Woo-wee. That is some good seasonal rye. And that'll get us going through the summer. I'm going to overseed this with Bermuda, and then we'll be good to go. But enjoy your new grassland, DaBaby. My adorable baby boy. Would you like a protein shake, Mr. DaBaby? A protein shake for these big, strong muscles? Well, I guess Pogger's getting out explains who's been doing this. But today, I am taking this egg that is definitely not going to hatch, and I'm going to try and sell it at the Waco's Farmer's Market. That's right, we're going to the Waco Farmer's Market. Kevin, you're not going to let me eat your egg? Oh, excuse me, sir. Sir, please let me take that egg. I'm going to need to go get the Riot Shield. Kevin, hey, are you running along to try and hurt me, sir? Oh, this is a very narrow gap. Oh, gosh. All right, guys, let's see if it works. I don't think he'll be able to get to me through heat. Also, I have this clean water for them, so they don't have to drink that, but I should just remove that anyways so they don't drink the algae. Good morning, Kyle, my handsome baby boy. Is this a Pepsi? Bro, that's vintage. Oh, Kevin, what are you doing, sir? I'm looking at this little Pepsi bottle. Oh, Kevin, stop. Stop it, sir, please. Don't take my Pepsi. I'm gonna push you back, sir. That'll show him. Oh, didn't see that coming, did you? There's a funeral going on next door. Kevin, did you not read my hat, sir? This is my POV, you guys. Oh my gosh. I don't like when he goes low, because I'm not. Oh my God. See, I don't like when he goes low, because then I can't really protect my sweet little thighs. Special thanks to our patrons, Felix and Gene, for sending me this. This is why I need to lift more often, you guys. Look at this. Pushing him does not hurt him, but it does show him that I am more alpha. Yeah, this thing. Oh, Kevin! Is that you? See how he turns away? Sadly, there still is a little bit of trash that I need to pick up in this little area here. Oh, is that Kevin? Oh, goodness gracious, sir. That doesn't feel good at all. I don't like you doing that one bit, sir. All right, that's all the trash I'm getting today. Now we're getting that egg. Look at the adorable little egg. Look at Queen over there. Looks like Karen's about to poo. But wow, take a look at this, you guys. Oh, hey, is that Kevin? Yes, sir, I do have your tiny little egg that would never hatch. This egg is infertile, Kevin. It's not gonna hatch. I don't care how many times you and Karen made it. It's too small. That's what I thought.
You see, guys, sometimes he listens to reason.
Oh!
Kevin is indeed a smart boy. He's learning how to circumvent the riot shield to get at my sweet, sweet thigh.
Back up, big man. You don't want zero problems, big fella.
Okay, that should be good. I'm gonna go ahead and take this and sell it at the farmer's market with my protein shake.
Got my two essentials for the farmer's market and my little hands. But yeah, guys, downtown Waco's got this farmer's market, you see, that I haven't been to in probably 3 or 4 years since I was a student here in this town. Now, I've heard that it's changed a lot. Regardless, we're going and we're gonna try and sell this egg without a stall. That's right, I did not pay for space at the farmer's market. I have not started doing that yet, but we will. And I'm gonna try and trade that egg for something there at the stalls.
This is it, you guys. Downtown Waco. Turn that off so I don't get demonetized. But here it is. This is where the farmer's market is. It's a bunch of yuppies, you guys. You'll see.
None of them are real country boys like me.
None of them.
Wait. All right, guys, here we are, downtown Waco Farmer's Market. Make sure you stay hydrated. Bring a gallon of water if you go. This is me running off to go and trade this egg for something epic. Name of Nightlight Donuts. They're not even a farm. I don't know why they're at the farmer's market, but let's see if we can make a trade.
Some nice bread.
And to help with bartering, I wore my amulet of Dibella and my Gibness potions.
This is a real egg. Would you guys be
food, or is it an animal?
It's food. It's too small to incubate, so you're not gonna hatch it. Normally they're about like this big.
I'll trade you one donut.
Donut? Really? Yeah.
And bada bing, bada boom, you guys. That's how it's done. As you can see, the amulet of Dibella worked. Those donuts are worth at least $3 to $4. They're way too expensive. Take a look at this.
And man, that's how it's done. What other farming channel will teach you how to sell your product at the markets, you guys? That's why you're gonna wanna hit subscribe.
But I am gonna show you guys the rest of the market. Take a look at this.
Farm fresh eggs.
But probably not as good as my eggs. These are our neighbors. These are the guys that I go dumpster diving for their old lettuce so I can feed it to my pigs and chickens. And there's a bunch of other small businesses that don't necessarily have anything to do with farming. So we're coming back.
That's the Waco Farmers Market. Pretty soon we're gonna get a little tent there for ourselves.
It's funny, half those things weren't even farms. This is just a little donut shop.
Joke's on them though, I have no idea how long that egg's been sitting out.
But come on down to Waco, guys. It's a pretty cool town. We also got some pretty cool hiking trails, name of Cameron Park. I got a little thing stuck in my foot here from some kind of cactus. And then look at these little yuccas. Very cool. Now, I'm a little rusty on my Espanoles, but I believe this says, please, let me look this up. I don't know what it said, you guys. Don't expect me to speak Spanish. This is Texas. Take a look at this. See this beautiful cliff? This tree is just barely growing here. It's amazing that these cedars can live like that. You can see all the leaves are starting to come back on all of our trees now. And if you come to Waco, you can see it from a kayak.
Hey, I just got back to my house, as you can see here. I think I see something under my house.
That's one of Poppy's babies. Okay, let me pick you up. Oh, come on. Dang it. All right, well, that's Poppy's baby, so they are still alive.
And for some reason, all the call ducks are outside of the fenced-in area. How's about you guys go on back? Come on, goofy little things. Come on, come on. Come on, guys, come on. Let's get you back. Let's go, let's go. No, come on, come on. Okay, just gave the dogs two scoops of this stuff. I'm gonna give one scoop in here for our neighborhood possums. Such a handsome man. And look at this adorable baby boy. It looks like the baby knocked this over and he's been eating all of it.
I took some dog food and I set this trap and then a possum immediately came out. I don't know if it's Poppy or another one because it doesn't really look like Poppy at all. It has a lot of different features.
And this place looks heckin' magical, if I do say so myself. What's up, gamers? I caught this possum outside my house last night, and I don't know if it's Poppy. In fact, I don't think it is. It doesn't look anything like her. And it has a huge flesh wound on the side and a big cut on its tail. Look at this wound on its side, you guys.
It's definitely not Poppy, but I fed her, gave her some water, and then I went ahead and let her go. This is little Queen. She sleeps under there for some reason. I don't know why. It's really cute. And Poggers sleeps in this top kennel. He likes to hop up in there in bed. It's very, very cute.
Poggers, why were you sleeping up there? He's got a little raised, lofted bed. But yeah, no Poppy in here, or no little babies in here either. I do hope that these guys aren't attacking our little local possums, but if they did, it would be kind of based, because that's kind of what they're supposed to do. Normal possums would kill our chickens and ducks, although I don't think Poppy would necessarily do that, but we do think that Poppy may have killed Nugget. Aaron, Kevin, and Kyle seem very happy today.
Do you guys have any good recommendations for potable algicides for livestock tanks? Let me know in the comments.
Come on down to the Urban Rescue Ranch, you guys. There's only one animal here that wants to kill you at all times and will follow you around until he can. But the rest of the animals are precious. Look at this little man.
Handsome one at that, too. Hey, stop scratching. Stop scratching. You're not supposed to scratch, sir.
Look at this tired little boy.
Don't actually come to my house, you guys. We are not open to public visitations. Also, the baby is getting very, very big. He's almost ready to fight Jake Paul.
Well, fellas, it's officially time to order new food for all the animals. They're all getting bigger. Look at this. They're all just getting tall and big and handsome and cute. Look at that cleavage. And look at the little red on his neck. That's why they call them red kangaroos. And what's an Urban Rescue Ranch video without an adorable footage of the obese prairie dog trying to get up on a couch? Look at this little man. Wow, he's getting really strong. Oh, almost made it.
You want to try again, buddy, or do you need some help? You want to try again?
He's so determined.
Oh, he's getting stronger. Look how determined this little man is to get up there.
But you can do it. You can do it. Come on. Yeah. Oh, so close that time.
Need a little help? Oh, there we go.
Anytime I do this, he just goes comatose.
Also, a ton of chicks hatched this morning, so we got a lot of work to do, boy.
But thanks so much for watching my video. I love you. I appreciate you. And we'll see you in the next video.
Are you gonna bite my hand?
Look how she just, yeah, she just bites my feet for no reason at all. Literally no reason at all. She just bites as hard as she can. I think she was just a wild caught little thing that was brought into the pet trade. And it's kind of sad. At the same time, it's kind of a meme in of itself. Look at this little fat boy. Why does she have to be so awful, but he's just so precious?
Thanks so much for watching my video. I love you. I appreciate you.
Almost forgot to tell you.